Welcome to Dance Festival. We are going to get started in about 30 seconds, so if you're looking for a seat, please find me quickly. In about 30 seconds, we get started. Some of you are not excited. Raise your hand. Raise your hand if you're only a little bit excited right now. If you're only a little bit excited right now. Okay, raise your hand if you're not excited right now. This is one of our favorite events of the year. We love your screaming, and the light, and this is the day where you can let loose. Everybody needs to be very quiet for just a few minutes. Just 2 minutes. That's all we need is 2 minutes of quiet. Because we're about to say a prayer. Okay? We're about to say a prayer, so we just need a little bit of quiet, and then once we finish with that, I'm going to hand the microphone over to Coach Bonner after the prayer is over, and at that point, we want to hear all of your excitement, every single little ounce of it. Okay, first of all, we need to just say thank you to a couple of people. I'm going to ask you to clap your hands, okay? You all have a couple of PE teachers who have helped you prepare for today, right? Coach Anderson. Coach Laycock. Coach Smith. And Coach Winnetana. And we have some ballroom instructors who help our ballroom crew. Mrs. Bond and Mr. Matthews. Let's give them a round of applause. Okay, one last little announcement before we go to the prayer. I want you to look over here to the front corner where you see Mrs. Adams and Coach Bonner. They are holding up some trophies that we recently acquired as a school. Our 5th through 8th grade ballroom teams went to BYU to participate in the National Dance Sport Competition, and they walked away with the number one top place prize for Team Sport. Okay, we are going to have a prayer now by Bentley Tackett. Once Bentley finishes praying, he's going to hand the microphone over to Coach Bonner, and then it's fun time. Okay, Bentley, thank you.
Our dear Heavenly Father, we're so grateful for this day. We're grateful that we can all come to this wonderful school today. Please bless those that are dancing, that they can perform and dance to the best of their abilities. So grateful for all the teachers that have helped out with everything at this school, and say since the name is Christ, amen.
Thank you, Ben.
American Heritage families and students, how are we feeling today? Okay, so we are in for some treats today. First, we're starting out with the third grade. They will be dancing to the Maple Dance. Young men decorated the pole with symbols depicting various trades of the region. The May Day celebration usually includes a process where the tree or pole is carried through the town followed by a brass band, intended to beat back the winter and welcome the coming of spring. The festivals are fun and usually conclude with a May Pole Dance.
Thank you.
on those enslaved on plantations. Both the dance and the song have had many variants, as the old folk song that it is. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the fourth grade!
Thank you.
called shaking maracas, which were made using the seed pods from a plant found in the West Indies. The cha-cha is the most popular dance among the Latin dancers. The Latin dancers are known for their expression of the heart, happiness, joy, and love. Make some noise for the Ballroom Apron! Great time. Remember, if you have family members that are not here, we are streaming this on YouTube. So you can send that YouTube link to your family around the world as we are celebrating all the cultures from around the world. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to hold on the ballroom and we're going to jump to the seventh grade girls. They are performing to Lollipop. Now the name of this dance is the Tiniquan dance. Tiniquan is a traditional Philippine folk dance. The dance involves two people beating, tapping, and sliding bamboo poles on the ground against each other. In coordination with one another, one or more dancers who step over it in between the pole and dances. It's pretty exciting. It is traditionally danced and rondada music played by an ensemble of stringed instruments which originated in Spain during the Middle Ages. Make some noise for your seventh grade girls!
It was most popular in America from 1830
1890. The origins of this dance come from the Scottish country dance, the highly real and perhaps even earlier influence from Irish dance. Give it up for Jimmy Real!
Second grade! So good!
The French Canadian dance tradition is a good example of culture, of both survival and revival norms. In Quebec, folk dances are those based on square and long waist formations. On some circle dances and on percussive rhythm pattern of the feet called the step dancing or gig. Many of these dances have an elite and noble history, such as the complex quadrille of F. D. Orleans. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the fifth grade! With their creativity and expressive movements in their amazing singing and dancing films. The Foxtrot was the most significant development in all of ballroom dancing. Ladies and gentlemen, the way you look tonight by Ballroom 8th graders. comes from the late 18th century. It has become a symbol of national unity and the national dance of Mexico, and is taught today in nearly every grade school in Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the first grade. The after-school ballroom dancers, Fit 6 and 7, please go to the locker rooms. Report to the locker rooms right now. Fit 6 and 7 after-school ballroom.
Let's go!
this afternoon, but it's amazing. It is the seventh grade boys hockey.
His name was Taropaha.
Taropaha
was a great leader. He had the support of his people. His reputation was even. Unfortunately, there were many who were envious, who were jealous. Taropaha met another tribe from Wakata, but he was not welcome. He was sent away, and a group of the most fierce warriors were instructed to kill him. The war party pursued him, and Taropaha fled for his life. He met with the people of Ngāti Tuwharetoa. Their chief, Wharerangi, welcomed him and offered him a place of protection. The war party arrived, but Te Wharerangi commanded them to stop. He said there is to be no war here, and commanded them to depart in peace. Te Rokoha thought he was going to die, but because of the support and love, he was able to overcome death and see another day. The story of Te Rokoha reminds us all that to lead and to be courageous, to help others and always be ready to serve. And no matter our weaknesses, our mistakes, or how difficult life can be, the support of family, loved ones, and most of all our Savior Jesus Christ, we will all overcome death and live to see a better day. Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the haka, kamata.
Again, let's give a round of applause to our dancers, to our coaches, to our ballroom dance instructors. Okay, it's now time for us to end this event. We'll see you again next year. And hey, what's going on?
We gotta believe in a miracle.
Thank you.